That's good. So the drill kind of sets you up to, you know, thinking that way, but you can also feel it's almost like your right palm is going to be up and towards the second baseman for just a smidge bit longer.
Try to stay in the middle.
Yep, you should really feel over the plate. There you go. Two more. Yeah.
Okay, so now you do angle drills at all for me and your size?
Sometimes.
Okay.
Not
so on this angle, on the open angle, but I'm going to flip to you again. So we've done like, so far we've gone half foil, drive the ball away. Then we went reverse toss, drive the ball away. Now we go open angle in. You're going to pull these, but your goal is to pull them with good spin. So think about this speaker. I want you to try to stay on this side of the speaker, at least on this side of the pole. Try to get good backspin to the pull side. I'm going to try to jam you. I think the key is, one, make sure that you're ready on time, and then two, just make sure that you don't, like I said before, get so coiled in the upper body, so turned in, that the only thing you can do to get there is feel that you've got to rip open. I want you to feel like, yeah, you get coiled here, and you get pulled back, but there's still space in here, and it's easy for you to get that ball. Because you made a pretty big move, that's a big move here. Because you made a big move, if you're late with that move because it's a bigger move, then I think it's going to pull off even more. If you get all this done early enough and you're set, I'm moving, but like I'm ready to go in any moment now. That becomes like really easy to get to the end. Okay, now give me three that you're gonna hit through my foot. So I'm gonna go through the way. Now stay on the way. Stay through the ball. Stay through the zone, feel like in first. You know, like sometimes you'll get almost too over rotated, or when the ball. Your body's not going to want to do this because the ball's coming from right here. So it may like soften your butt just a little bit. The idea of the drill is the same. When we go in, you're pulling, but have a good spin on it. You're probably going to get some power from it. When we go away, that's probably going to be the hardest one. You've got to stay over the plate on the ball, feel your barrel working this way as you're trying to push it. So let's start away, then we'll go in. Okay. So let's go four away first. And I'm going to throw these like right on the outer end.
Okay.
So I'm going to try to go like, hopefully, third. these are the good ones where it's like the ball's coming in, but don't feel like you're going to pull too hard with your other body. See if you can just, like, that load is not too much, and then you've got space in here to be able to just work your hands inside.
Well, that's the other guy. 160. And you that one was
nice. That's about as hard as it's going to get, because that ball was hitting off the plate.
Yeah, now see? Chale. That pitch was up on the outside kind of.
We're just talking about that empty skin. Slow and fast. So you can cover more of the hitting zone. So I'm going to flip balls to the outside part of the plate. You're always going to hit when I flip the ball. And then I flip it outside, you hit it. If I don't flip it, so every now and then I'm going to go like this. I'm going to go here, and I'm going to hold it. So you're always anticipating getting ready for that pitch that's going to be middle away. And then if you don't get it, how quickly can you then adjust and get that inside? Okay. Okay. So it's a little bit of like, a little bit of a two strike where you're looking for where to react again. But same thing, like you have to be in control of your body. You have to stay in the hitting zone for a long time. You can't jump too much. If you get jumped, you get really hard and then hit that inside pitch.
Very good.